Staff Sergeant Paul Henry walks along the top of a section of the levee in Fort Pierre. He says normally there's at least two team members, if not more, monitoring different sections of the levee 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Henry says they're looking for anything that will compromise the integrity of the levee system.
We're trained to look for flow that may be coming underneath the dike. We're trained to look for boils or sand boils as they may be, any sloughing or any problems with the seepage coming in under the dike that carries any kind of sediment.
Henry says crews also have to watch for debris coming down the river to make sure it doesn't poke holes in the plastic coating that covers the riverside of the dike.
You can see here there's a little bit of debris that's accumulated just outside the dike. The problem is when tree trunks get washed down containing a lot of branches, they can rip this thing open pretty easily.
Henry says they use good old-fashioned duct tape and sandbags to repair minor holes in the plastic. He says they also monitor sewer drains, which have caused some problems over the past few days.
The problem with the storm sewer drain is once the river level went up, of course, the higher water pressure forced water out into the dry side of the dike. So that had to be sealed, and they used a rather ingenious method of sealing it. They actually put an inflatable device inside the storm drain on the riverside and added air pressure to that to make a complete seal and seal off that storm drain so the water could no longer come through to the dry side of the dike.
Henry says crews don't just monitor from on top of the dike. He says they patrol neighborhoods and walk along the edge of the dike, or what they call the toe. Henry walks down to one area they've been closely monitoring.
And if you look at it, you can see that it's wet. It's got some moisture coming through here. That in itself isn't too unusual because it's obviously holding back a lot of Missouri River.
Henry walks a little further back from the toe where water has seeped up through the ground.
What we typically look for when we come to an area with seepage is we look for any sediment that's being carried underneath the dike and eroding the integrity of the dike. This doesn't appear to have it. It actually looks pretty good, and we've been monitoring this for days now.
Henry says if there are any problems with the levee, it's immediately reported and crews are sent to make repairs. He says quick reaction forces are standing by in case a major breach in the levee occurs. For South Dakota Public Broadcasting, I'm Jackelyn Severin in Pierre.